Summon the dancing crew to perform right now. I'm in a dirty mood.
From different places in the east have finally arrived at the palace gates on the assumption that the king will be born in the palace. Their arrival definitely caused some commotion at the palace gates. People wondered why there were so many people at the palace. Reached the ears of King Herod. He was basking in his entertainment. The king summons his guards to bring the majority of his force. The soldiers rush to the gates and bring the majority in.
Let's follow the Magi.
They saw the child and the mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him.
The angel standing out there.
Then they opened their treasure and presented him with gifts of gold.
Frankincense.
And myrrh.
Tonight? No.
And having been born in a dream, not to go back to King Herod, they returned to their country by another route.
So, this is kind of
Kero, take the child and his mother and escape to Egypt. Stay there until I tell you for Herod is going to search for the child and kill him.
Hearing this, Joseph took Jesus and Mary and they fled to Egypt.
Another king? Ha ha ha! What sort of things is this? It's a death kiss to everyone I've known. Everything I've won for my own. To kings, it can't be so. I cannot rule, and this king also. No! There will be but one king in this country, and that king will be me. Because if I let this heavenly king take the reins, what remains of my rule? I will not be made a fool. This king must die, so I can live just how I always have, with me in charge.
Great King Herod, I fear those Magi. On their way back home, they have passed us by.
They have tricked me. I'll kill every boy under two and more if I have to. There cannot be two kings, and yet there is. No, there can be only one. So is it me or is it him? Come on, my soldiers. I command you to kill all your children below the age of two.
The soldiers rush out from the palace, go out to execute the plan, killing all the Alice misfitted. This prophet, what the prophet Jeremiah foretold, a voice is heard in Ramah, weeping and great mourning. Rachel weeping for her children and refusing to be comforted because they are no more.